Okay, let's talk a bit about complex periodic waveforms. Let's start by making sure we understand those two adjectives. What makes a waveform periodic, and what makes a waveform complex? Periodic waveforms are waveforms whose patterns of air pressure change constantly repeat. A period is the amount of time occupied by one cycle of a waveform, and a periodic waveform is repeating the same cycle. Complex waveforms consist of more than one frequency. So a sine wave, a single frequency, is not complex. It's a simple waveform. But anything other than that simple sine wave is going to be a complex waveform. So complex periodic waveforms must contain more than one frequency, and they must have a repeating pattern of change in air pressure. There are an infinite number of possible complex periodic waveforms. Literally infinite. But there are three complex periodic waveforms that we see a lot, and it's useful to know both their shape and their harmonic construction. So the three waveforms I want to focus on are sawtooth waves, triangle waves, and pulse waves. Pulse waves are also called rectangle waves, and they're also related to square waves, which we'll talk about later. In talking about these waveforms, I want to talk about three things. I want to talk about which harmonics they contain. Again, harmonics are whole number multiples of the fundamental. I want to talk about the amplitude of those harmonics, and I want to talk about the phase of those harmonics. Starting with the sawtooth wave contains all harmonics. The amplitude of those harmonics is 1 over the harmonic number. So the second harmonic is half the amplitude of the fundamental. The third harmonic is a third, and so forth. Also in the sawtooth wave, every other harmonic is 180 degrees out of phase. So that means if your fundamental starts by moving towards high pressure, your second harmonic is going to start by moving towards low pressure. Third high, fourth low, and so forth. We take all of these frequencies, all of these sine waves, and add them together at this combination, and we get the shape of a sawtooth wave. The sawtooth wave contains a lot of harmonics, so you can say it has a kind of buzzy sound. And in synthesis, it's a really nice sound to start with if you're planning on doing a lot of filtering, because it has all of those harmonics that you can filter out in interesting ways. In comparison, let's look at a triangle wave. A triangle wave doesn't contain all of the harmonics. It only contains odd harmonics. So there's the fundamental. It doesn't contain a frequency that's 2 times the fundamental, only one that's 3, 5, 7, etc. Also, the amplitude of these harmonics is 1 over the harmonic number squared. So that means the third harmonic is 1/9 of the amplitude of the fundamental. The fifth is 1/25, etc. So the triangle wave has far fewer harmonics, and also much quieter harmonics. In the triangle wave 2, every other harmonic is 180 degrees out of phase. So again, if your fundamental starts by going towards high pressure, your third harmonic is going to start by going towards low pressure, fifth high, seventh low, etc. Because there are fewer harmonics, and these harmonics are a lower amplitude, the triangle wave sounds much smoother, some people comparing it to a clarinet sound. Next, let's talk about a square wave, which is a kind of pulse wave, a kind of rectangle wave. Just as you think about shapes, a square is a kind of rectangle. It's a rectangle that has equal sides. A square wave, like a triangle wave, contains only odd harmonics. The amplitude, though, is different. The amplitude of these harmonics is 1 over the harmonic number. Remember, the triangle was 1 over the harmonic number squared. But so in a square wave, the amplitude of the third harmonic is 1/3 of the fundamental, not 1/9 like the triangle. Finally, in a square wave, all of the harmonics are in phase. That means when the fundamental starts going up, so does the third, fifth, seventh, etc. As we said, square waves are a type of rectangle wave. Rectangle waves have a property called their duty cycle, or pulse width. This is the percent of the waveform that is above the zero axis. So, in a square wave, half of the waveform is above the axis, half of the waveform is below. But in other kinds of rectangle waves, these might have different ratios. In the old NES and Game Boys, for example, they could produce rectangle waves at 50%, 75%, 25%, and 12.5%. We encounter rectangle and pulse waves a lot in synthesis because they're very easy to make. We just need to switch something on and off really quickly, between 20 or 20,000 times a second. Digitally, these are ones and zeros, so a very easy waveform to produce. The harmonic makeup of a rectangle wave changes as you change its duty cycle. We'll set aside the math of that for the moment, but as that harmonic spectrum changes, so will the timbre. Since we understand the harmonic makeup of a sawtooth wave, triangle wave, or square wave, we can produce them all through additive synthesis by combining sine waves together. But probably that's not the most efficient solution. Digitally, it's going to be far more effective, for example, to have a sawtooth wavetable that we cycle through, rather than combining perhaps hundreds of sine waves to create that sawtooth wave. With wavetable synthesis, we can create complex waveforms, complex periodic waveforms, with just a single oscillator, an effective way to quickly get harmonically rich material.